Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI Masked Entry Control. The Syncfusion .NET MAUI Masked Entry Control is a powerful tool that allows you to restrict user input to a specific pattern or format using a mask. With this control, you can create templates for providing information in various formats, such as telephone numbers, email IDs, IP addresses, and product keys. In this video, I will demonstrate how to add Syncfusion's .NET MAUI Masked Entry Control to a .NET MAUI project. I will show you how to restrict certain characters and customize prompt characters. I will also demonstrate how to set values and cultures. Before you begin, please ensure that you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the necessary .NET MAUI workload. Additionally, make sure that you have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click on Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application. Then, provide the project name and location. After that, proceed to create the project using the .NET 7.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before I move forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the environment for running the application. Here, I select the Android emulator from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. Now, I will run the application and show you the default output. The application compiles a default code, so wait for a few seconds. Now, the application's homepage is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate the masked entry control into this application. For that, I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI inputs NuGet package. So, I first open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI inputs package and select it to install in my project. After the package is installed, I need to register the handler for Syncfusion Core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. To do this, I open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI Core hosting namespace. Then, register the Syncfusion Core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion Core method. To use the Syncfusion MAUI controls, it is necessary to register a trial license key. I open the app XAML CS file and add the register license method with the trial license key. You can generate a trial license key by following the instructions provided in the description below. Next, navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. I remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI inputs namespace. Then, initialize the control. Look here, the .NET MAUI masked entry control is displayed on the emulator, occupying the entire screen. Now, you can enter any values by default. To customize the UI, I load the control inside a stack layout and set its width to 200. Now, as you can see, the control is displayed at the top of the screen and its width has been adjusted accordingly. Now, let me show you how to restrict the values in the control by using the two types of mask, such as simple and regular expressions. Let's start with simple. This type is used for expressions that contain letters, digits, and special characters. It is mainly used for fixed-length values. For example, phone numbers. To demonstrate this, I will set the mask type property to simple and the mask property to an appropriate value. Now, check here, you will only be able to enter numeric values with 10 digits, simulating a phone number input. Next, move on to the regular expression. This type is used for expressions in mask for validating more complex input formats, such as validating an email ID. To demonstrate this, I will add a new masked entry control. Then set its mask type property to regular expression and the mask property to the appropriate pattern for validating an email ID. Check here, you will be able to enter an email ID that matches the specified pattern. Next, let's move on to customizing the prompt character. By default, the underscore is displayed as a prompt for each masked character when there is no output. Now, in the first control, I set the prompt character property to hashtag, and in the second control, to dash. You will observe that the prompt is customized according to the specified values. Next, let's move on to setting support for different cultures in terms of currency symbols, dates, times, groups, and decimal separators. If you want to enter a currency in dollars, you can achieve this by setting the mask property to the dollar symbol with leading zeros. Now, you can enter the currency amount with the dollar symbol. Now let me show you how to set a value programmatically. To achieve this, set the value property to the desired value. In this case, I will set it to 4000. See, the specified value, 4000, is displayed in the masked entry control. Next, I will show you how to enable the clear button. By default, the clear button visibility is set to never. To enable this, set the clear button visibility to while editing. Now, when you edit the values, the clear button is visible. In this video, I have shown you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add Syncfusion's masked entry control to it. I also demonstrated how to restrict characters and customize the prompt character, as well as how to set the value programmatically and provide culture support. To learn more about masked entry features, you can check the documentation link provided in the description below. Additionally, I have included a link for you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.